Hummingbirds, they are tiny animals that, despite being tiny, they're super bold. And they can fly very fast, so they are not easily caught. They are like a weird in between birds and insects, because the way they fly, because how fast they can do things. And they are pollinators, which means that they feed on flowers, on the nectar, and the flowers give that nectar to reproduce. Hi, I'm Alejandro Rico-Guevara. I study hummingbirds and other animals that drink nectar as well. Hummingbirds have a totally different approach to flight. They produce the lift both when the wing is moving forward and then when the wing is moving backwards. They usually move their wings about, you know, from 30 to 50 times a second. And that allows them to stay hovering in the same place, even fly backwards or like fly upside down almost, which is something no other bird can do. But just by standing still, you're spending so much energy. So feeding is something that is vital, and that's what fascinates me. Studying hummingbirds, at first I was just going out with binoculars and trying to, you know, to follow them. But there are some behaviors, especially in animals that move so fast, that you just cannot perceive. So that led me to high-speed cameras. Different lenses, macro lenses, the proper lighting setup, etc., etc. The way hummingbirds get their food is very specialized. So we wanted to actually see how this process would work and you know, like understand the details of the feeding. It was thought that hummingbirds would drink using tube-like tongues, like a straws. And that's not what we saw. First, when the tongue is inside the nectar, it's not a tube anymore. The tongue is spread out. And then all of the structures just fold back in and then trap little drops of nectar. There is a micro pump that can spring open and fill with nectar. And then there is this racking of the tongue base, sort of like wrings the nectar out. So it's way more intricate than we would have expected or that is known for any other bird. Until very recently, high-speed cameras and macro lenses were just prohibitively expensive. Having images was crucial. The fact that you have the evidence that anybody can look at and anybody can measure is huge for science.